We have gathered here today, unfortunately not the first time, in front of the Israeli consulate in the city of Montreal. This is the consulate which represents the state of Israel, which is a terrible tragedy for humanity. It's a crime against the Holy Torah, Judaism, and is a danger for the Jewish people. You can see the photographs we are displaying here today. These are our brethren, anti-Zionist Orthodox Jews in the Holy Land. They are being brutally beaten by the Israeli police. People are being injured and blood is being spilled. Why are they treated like this? Why are they brutalized? Which crime have they committed to deserve this treatment? Obviously, they are not armed and they are not causing any threat and any danger to anyone. The simple crime they are committing is when they are standing up to preserve and protect ancient cemeteries, grave sites of their ancestors and their rabbis. They are protesting the digging of an ancient cemetery in the city of Beth Shemesh, close to Jerusalem, where there is hundreds of graves that are thousands of years old. They are protesting, they are preserving, actually. They're preserving one of the basics of Jewish belief, which is the belief in afterlife, that the soul is eternal, and that the human body should not be destroyed even after that. Which nation in the world does disrespect graves? Which nation in the world can we find a history of destroying cemeteries as we see the history in the so-called state of Israel already going on for decades? Where in the world, in our day and age, are religious Jews who stand up to protect their religion brutalized in such a terrible manner? What we witness today, this violation of human rights, is unfortunately not the first. This is not the only incident we see. This is repeating itself already for decades against Jewish people and against others. This uprooting of Jewish religion is not just now happening. This is happening already for a long time, which is very terrible and very disastrous. This is painful and embarrassing for Jewish people, since all of this is being done supposedly in the name of Jewish people. The entire occupation of Palestine is a crime from the very beginning. The philosophy of Zionism is heresy from the very beginning. And the mere existence of the state of Israel is contrary to the teachings of the Torah, the Jewish religion. According to Judaism, according to basic Jewish belief, Jews are in exile by divine decree. Ever since the destruction of the Second Temple, about 2,000 years ago, God has dispersed the Jewish people amongst the nations. We are required to be loyal citizens in the countries where we reside. Canadian Jews are loyal to Canada, American Jews to the United States and elsewhere. We are required to be in peace with our neighbors. We are forbidden to create a sovereign homeland of our own, and we are forbidden to wage wars against any nation or to oppress our non-Jewish neighbors. We are waiting for the day, for the ultimate redemption, when God Himself will reveal His glory throughout the universe, all people would accept His kingdom and worship Him together in peace. As we say in the prayers of our high holidays that we are approaching right now, V'ayusi chilam agidu eichas, la'asos ritzoinchu b'laivav shulaim. And all people will form one bond to serve the Almighty with whole hearts. It is because the Zionists disbelieve. They don't believe in the divine decree of exile. Therefore, they created this so-called State of Israel. It's because they disbelieve the concept that the soul is sacred and eternal. Therefore, they allow and support the digging of graves. It's because they disregard the Ten Commandments, which says, thou should not kill and thou should not steal. Therefore, they are killing the Palestinian people and stealing their land. And it's because they refuse to practice Jewish tradition and believe in Jewish religion. Therefore, they are oppressing Jewish people, religious Jewish people who stand up to protect their religion. But after all, the Jewish people are still loyal to Almighty God and to His Torah. And for decades, Orthodox Jews worldwide oppose the existence of the State of Israel, the cruel behavior of them against Jewish people and non-Jewish people. They are against the heresy of Zionism against Jewish religion and oppose the uprooting of Jewish tradition. And this opposition is not only in other lands, this is actually inside of the Holy Land, despite all intimidation and harassments. Our people in the Holy Land don't fear the Zionist regime. And they are not becoming intimidated. They are standing up and opposing whatever is happening there. This heroic opposition to Zionism proves a very important point. It illustrates the great difference between Jews, a religious people, versus Zionists, a political people. The difference between Judaism, which is a religion only, and no politics to it, versus the philosophy of Zionism, the movement of Zionism, which is a political nationalistic movement void of godliness. The brutal treatment that the Zionist police, the Israeli police, is brutalizing religious Jews shows that the State of Israel is not a Jewish state. The State of Israel is trying to present itself as the representation of all Jews and as the saviors of the entire Jewish people. And this is wrong. They are not the security of the Jewish people. It happens to be that they are causing a terrible threat, a hate of the Jewish people. They are out there just for the interests of their state and for support of their Zionist movement. We turn to the nations of the world to see and understand that the State of Israel is not only oppressing the Palestinian people, the non-Jewish inhabitants of the land. They are oppressing, intimidating, torturing the Jewish people as well, whoever stands in their way and doesn't go along with their philosophy and their motivations. We plead with the international community, organizations for human rights, and people of justice and kindness. Please come to our rescue to save our people in the Holy Land and save the entire Jewish people from this illegitimate State of Israel. We firmly say that we rather hope for a non-Jewish government in Israel. We would be far more safe. It'll be in accordance of our religion, and it would be fair and just for the Palestinian people. And finally, we pray for the speedy and peaceful dismantlement of the entire state of Israel. We hope that should be in peace without suffering of any people, Jews or non-Jews. And at that time, we hope that we would once again see merit to experience that peace that did exist in the past prior to this movement of Zionism. And we hope that this should be the case in the future. We should all live in peace and serve the one God together in harmony. Thank you very much.
So speaks Rabbi Feldman. Ça, c'est le rabbin Feldman qui vient de parler pour le Torah Karta.
Oh, that's